Drew Tube. Welcome to Hashtag Religion Week TV. I'm your host, Drew L. Murray, and here we sip a lot of tea with no shade, talking everything up the Yahweh. Enjoy the video. Tea, no shade. Hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that divides wicked imagination, feet that be swift and run into mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies, and the last seventh one is a brethren who sows discord. Somebody out here running around purposely. Now, let me just say this. Christ brought a variance. It's in your Bible. You can live in the same house with somebody. Somebody will get Christ and somebody will not receive him. That brings a division, a variance. The church is divided. Some people get Christ, some people don't get Christ. It's in your book, I think it's the book of Matthew, when he talks about bringing a variance, a division. Not that he's a divisor. Some people just don't want the truth. Some people just don't want the kingdom of heaven. Some people just don't want to build temples in their heart. They'd rather build churches in the world, fill them with a lot of demonic spirits, and call it church. I'm sorry. People who know you speaking the truth, but oh, don't believe her, she's a liar, that's sowing discord. People who, hold on, Facebook. We almost done here. I don't want to get too ahead of, YouTube. I don't want to get too ahead of Facebook. Thank you, Talaka. So, people who go out here and know you honest and true to what you're doing. Oh, don't deal with her. Oh, she's smoking. She ain't holy. Oh, her and her daughter got issues. I wouldn't care who you live with, how you live with them. God called you. It's going to be opposition and persecution. You just got to rise above that regardless of what people say about you. But those are the ones sowing discord. Those are the ones going behind your back talking about you to other people to make your ministry not grow or to make people not side with you in life on what you're saying, regardless if they know you're true or not. There's people out there sowing discord all in the church with the he say, she say. Let me show you how they doing it because they have a proud look. You hear a lot of pastors say, ooh, I just preached them under the table. Ooh, I sure preached a good sermon. Not giving God no glory, okay? Not giving God no reference. They said they just preached a good sermon. Ain't give God 1 ounce of glory. When God says everything you do, do it unto the Lord. Number two, they have lying tongues. That right there, you didn't preach nobody down. If God gave you that word to preach, then God just helped you preach them people down. But that's a lying tongue right there. Okay, not just picking on the pastors or the preachers of the church. This is all of us out here calling ourselves Christians and believers and sanctified, holy, this, that, and everything else, okay? This is just not the church. This is just not the church. It's everybody out here. Just one more second. Alright, so, the proud look, the lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood. I mean, I've heard stories of some pastors that's pastors now, allegedly Paula White, that you might have had something to do with another pastor's murder, killing down there in Tampa, Florida somewhere, and you ended up with his church. Now, if that's going on in the church, allegedly, people, then that's hands that shed an innocent blood right in the church. You got people. We don't know if Dylan, that guy that walked in and shot up that church, was Christian or not, but God's house is under attack with people going in shedding innocent blood. You got people, again, like I said, your family members, your friends, your co-workers shedding innocent blood when they keep you from fulfilling your dreams or fulfilling your spirituality in God, in Yahweh. That there's a lot of innocent blood out here being shed, but primarily it's talking about physically killing somebody, absolutely. But then God showed me that other people are being slaughtered spiritually, and the blood of Jesus is not being plead over them or dipped in the blood of Jesus. But their blood is being shed because of people who's supposed to have the truth and not giving it to them. One second, we're almost gonna wrap this up. Almost there. Thank you, Facebook. Thank you, Salaka. Almost there. So, you have a proud look, lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked imaginations, that God says in the book of Genesis 6 through 5 and 6, somewhere there, that a man's heart is continually evil. But a repentant heart, God knows has truly been repentant, is not evil. That's the difference between our hearts. One is truly repentant and one may not be repentant. And if you're still out here doing this stuff right here that we just read in the book of Proverbs 6, 16 through 20. Well, we did 16 through 19. Let's just get on with it. This God hates this stuff and it's an abomination. And it's right in your Bible. But then you have feet that be swift into running to mischief. You the one causing all of chaos and confusion. You have to know that the devil is the author of confusion. Christ is the author and finisher of your faith, not confusion. There's a lot of confusion out there with Christianity and with Christ. And if somebody's saying something a little stronger than you on meat, that doesn't mean you should get offended. Hold on, YouTube. Facebook is coming back in. Hold on. This bear, we almost done here. So yeah, so if and then you have the feet that's running to be swift into mischief, and if you're the one out here causing the drama, the confusion, the chaos, that's ungodly, point blank. There's no way you as a Christian, as a believer, should be out here even partaking in this, because if that's you, God hates you on one account or on all seven accounts. And I'm just trying to let you know. So you sitting there posting, oh, how can people say this and they living like that? Man, am I living like this? If I was living like this, I wouldn't care how your soul lived. Because generally, when people live like this, they don't care about you, period. And you got a lot of these people living like this in your circle, don't even care about your soul. They don't care whether you go to heaven or hell. And you're out here mad at me because I do. It's okay. I'm not the Christian still on milk. I've grown to be on meat. I've grown to be in the word in me. I'm in the presence of God. God is in my presence. Does it all equate money? You've been deceived again, because you can't serve two gods, God or mammon. Mammon is the spirit of money, and some of y'all out there calling Jesus, which is money, mammon, your God. I don't want that. That's your Jesus, your mammon, your money, okay? That's Jesus. Hold on, YouTube. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. So, yeah. Okay. So, that's what mischief is. Causing all this chaos and confusion. Why? So that the truth can shine where it needs to shine, and you will be the one still getting all the glory while everybody else still out here struggling with their walk. No, stop it. Stop letting people confuse you and get you caught up in confusion, because it's devilish. The devil is the author of confusion. He's the chaos, the contention, all of that. Cantankerous, all that's the devil, those C words. You don't want to be a part of that. So, a false witness that speaketh lies. Why are you lying on people? Why, God hates people who speak bare false witness. It says it in the Ten Commandments, and it's saying it pretty much here. He don't like for you to bear false, because he have some people out here that really have his name attached to their life, and you out here making people look bad. Because you don't want to grow and answer your calling that God put on your life, so you want to infringe on other people's walk and relationship with the Lord. And that's what ministry is, getting as many people to follow the word of God that you can. Not even follow the word of God, repent and turn their life over to God so God can deal with them. That's it. If we remain friends after that, so be it. If not, I did my calling. I did what God asked me to do. That's get you to see the truth, get you to look back at Yahweh through Christ, however you want to go to it, Christians. We know we've been taught a certain way, but if you want to get back to Yahweh, that's all he's asking me to do. And I'm being willing and obedient doing that. And that should not hold on, Facebook, we almost done. Thank you, Salapa. So that's the whole thing right there. Your heart has to be willing and obedient to do what God called you to do. And for you to stand in anybody's way of what God asked them to do is ungodly. I don't care how you look at it. Like I said, I put a post up the other day. You trust your barber, you trust your hair salon, you trust your doctor's office, your church pastor, you trust your realtor, your car salesman, you trust your friends, the person in the club making your drinks on the weekend who could be putting mollies and pollies and pills and bills and all that other stuff up in there. You trust all these people with your life, and they can't save your soul. And here, half of y'all on my page, 762 friends, probably know me from Hudson, from my youth. And all I'm saying is, this is what God is showing me. And you treat me like I'm the devil. I gotta laugh at that, because some of y'all still living like the devil. And you mad at me. Because like I said, once you become with God, in God, once you start crying out and seeking ye the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, God will add the rest. So you get thick skin. The Bible told Ezekiel to make your forehead like flint. Hey, thank you, Salapa. So yeah, the Bible told Ezekiel, make your forehead like flint. There's going to be some people out there that's going to steady come against you and persecute you for Christ's name's sake, for the real truth. You see all these Christians out here ain't being persecuted on Facebook? They ain't holding no damn truth with them. They ain't making no difference. They ain't making no... Jesus brought a variance. He didn't come to make everybody on one accord. I'm making a variance, though. I'm the one being hated on. I'm the one being crucified because of what I'm saying. And let me tell you something. Christ said himself, if they hate me, they're going to hate you. So if you find yourself being liked by everybody, and you may not be as godly as you think you are. But I was saying, I have 762 friends on Facebook. Half of y'all probably only my friend because we come from Hudson. Half of y'all only probably know me when I lived in Hudson. And I left Hudson back in 95. You know nothing about me. You don't even know me. You only going off of what somebody else who think they know me. You been to my house. You rode in my car. You ate dinner with me. We go to church together. Have we sat down and read this Bible? Then you don't know nobody. Hold on, YouTube. Almost done. Almost done. So, yeah. Thanks, Salapa. So, it's like, you just have to say, have you ever ate at my house? Have you ever been in my car? Have you ever been on my job? Have you ever been to church with me? Have we sat down and break bread together, read the Bible? How can you say you know somebody? How? You only going off of what you heard or what somebody else don't like somebody for whatever reason. And that's how so many of y'all are deceived and oppressed and enslaved by your master, according to Colossians 3:22. Slaves, obey your master. And now you may like somebody, but because somebody else don't like them and they tell you, I don't mess with that person, you a slave. I don't deal with slaves. I don't deal with oppression. I don't deal with slaves. Y'all can have that. As Arsenal says, I ain't even mad at that. Okay? I'm going to tell you what God is mad at and what God hate. Okay? And if we fit this description, we need to do something about it. Whether you call yourself a Christian, a believer, the way of God, Jesus follower, Christ like, I don't care what you call yourself. If it got to do with the word of God, white, black, or indifferent, you need to check yourself. Do a soul check and see if you fit this description. Because a lot of the things that's going on in the world is because of people like this. People like this. People who think they got everything on their own, too damn proud to let somebody else get somewhere in life. Hold on, YouTube. You got to wait. Facebook got to hear this. You got to wait. Wait. You got to hear this. I apologize. So, we're going to wrap it up, Salafa. This is my point right here. It's people out here in this world, Christian, believer, white, black, old, young, I don't care at this point in time. I'm speaking on behalf of God. Yes, thus saith the Lord. These six things doth the Lord hate. Yea, seven are an abomination unto him. A proud look. You out here saying you got everything on your own, giving God no credit, and you're not allowing other people to get where they got to get in God, okay? And then you got that lying tongue. Oh, I did this myself. Oh, don't mess with me. You just go out here with a lying tongue. Everything you say, lying. Everything that come out your mouth is a lie. Because you're trying to seek glory and fame of men. And God talks about recognition of men or recognition and rewards being in heaven. Then you got hands that shed innocent blood. You out here hating on people because of what they trying to do with their life. And you steady shedding the innocent blood who you trying to keep. God says, feed my sheep. And if you trying to keep somebody from the truth, you're shedding innocent blood. I look at it like that spiritually. You killing people with your swords, your knives, your guns, and all that stuff. I get it. But you're also killing people spiritually. Hold on, YouTube. Thank you, Salafa. Thank you, Facebook. So, yeah. So, you're out here killing innocent blood, shedding innocent blood. If you kill with an instrument, a gun, knife, you know, that's killing innocent blood. Shedding hands, that's shedding innocent blood. But spiritually, if you're keeping somebody from the truth, if you don't allow people to go to church, to read their Bible, to seek ye the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, you are shedding innocent blood. Because those people get mad, they get angry, they get hostile at the people who are following their dream in God, and they revert back to the world, finding themselves doing the things that everybody accused them of doing anyway. You can't be that kind of believer nowadays. You gotta be the strong one. I am the strong one. And you just stick to what God called you to do and know you're doing it right. So, after you shed innocent blood, your heart is devising wicked imaginations against people. You out there got people thinking, people doing all sorts of stuff that they ain't even doing, honey. Let me tell you, you on this bandwagon. Hold on, YouTube. We wrapping it up. We're going to wrap this up in 1 second. Hold on. All right. So, yeah. So you got that heart that's just evil. You say evil things about people. You post evil things about people. But you ain't man or woman enough to put the name with the person you even trying to post about. You trying to clap at somebody and you just randomly throwing it out there, hoping the person pick up on it. That's evil. I don't care what you say. Your heart is devising wicked imaginations against people when you call them the devil. I've been called the devil before. I don't know about you or anybody else on here, but I have. That's devising wickedness against people. Actually, when you say stuff like that out your mouth against people, you could really very well be cursing a person and don't even know it. You need to know what a C-U-R-S-E is. And you'll stop saying a lot of stuff out your mouth toward people. And again, people stay prayed up, put the whole armor of God on, and know no weapon formed against you shall prosper, according to Isaiah 54:17. But then you become, you have these feet that's swift, quick to go to mischief. You be the first one on the scene. Ooh, what happened, child? Ooh, what happened to this? Oh, why they break up? Oh, why they ain't married no more? Oh, why this? Oh, why that? Oh, why you so damn nosy and quick to run your feet to mischief? Did you know God hates you? Did you know that this is something God hates? Oh, yeah. I'm almost done, YouTube. Hold in there. But this is something God hates. This isn't something I told you. I'm starting to learn whatever God hates, I need to start hating. Because at one point, I was like, ooh, God loves everybody. But obviously, he doesn't. He doesn't. And if you fit the category right, these ain't rocks that's doing this. This ain't bread. These is people with these characteristics he's talking about. Read all of chapter 6 if you don't believe me. I said I was going to start with verse 12. And it says, a naughty person, a wicked man, walketh in with a froward mouth. Some of y'all got a froward mouth out there. I say shit, damn, ass, and hell every now and then. Most of it's in the Bible. So why can't we say it? But anyway, y'all out there saying some foul, froward stuff with your mouth. The Bible says, let not corrupt, ill corrupt manner talk, conversation come from fiend lips, come from your mouth. But y'all out here calling yourselves Christians, saying some of the most corrupt, adulterated, blasphemous stuff out your mouth. And some of it ain't even biblical. What is biblical, you have it confused, and why you saying it doesn't even reference the context you're saying it in. Hold on, Facebook. I'm not very apologetic for much YouTube, but I do apologize for Facebook, the slow service. As I said earlier, Spectrum will be here on the 22nd. And I will have better internet service, okay? Gotta do what you gotta do until you can do better. And even if you're doing better, sometimes it's okay to go visit your free public library. Yes, I'm plugging the Albany Public Library system. And go utilize some of the free stuff they have for you and your family. Especially books, so you can educate yourself. I just happen to know they have the hot spot Wi-Fi there. So I take advantage of that. But like I said, trying to grow my business now, I need stable, secure internet. Because as you see, I try to run. My laptop is running. My Nook is running. I have this phone. It's just this phone. I have this Nook right here. Not to just be putting it out there, but okay, you can see this Nook. It's like my research Nook. But I be trying to run it all on this little hot spot, and it doesn't work, guys. So God is allowing me to grow in that area, and that's all it's about, is growth. I don't care if you've been a Christian for 50 years, there's some growth in you. So we're almost done. I'm at my hour time here. I think it's been an hour. We're not going any longer. As soon as Facebook come back in, we're going to wrap it up. We are going to wrap it up. We are going to wrap it up. Okay, so if I go back to Proverbs 6 and 13, it says, he winketh his eyes. It's still talking about the naughty, froward man speaking with his mouth. He winketh his eyes and speak with his feet. He teaches with his fingers. Okay. I know we just read that they swift with their feet to run the mischief. All that finger stuff, I gotta ask God. I used to be an eye winker, and I still like to wink my eye. This is not in the sense like, oh, I'm ungodly or anything like that. But when I read this, you want to stop winking your eye, because people going to think you one of these froward people that wink his eye, speak with, and speak with his feet. How you speak with your feet when the gospel of peace supposed to be on your feet? That's the only speaking you supposed to do, have the gospel of peace on your feet. That's the only thing your feet supposed to be talking is peace. Not running around here talking with your feet, quick with your feet, running to mischief and stuff like that. This is not godly, Christian. This is what, and y'all be the first ones to say it. And for you godparents out there, I don't know why they put God with godparents, and some of y'all is ungodly. I said it, and I'm going to do a topic on it, okay? I'm going to do a topic on godparents, ungodly godparents, and kids who make bad choices. That's what it's called. Hold on, YouTube. So, yeah, so I was saying, how do you put God with godparents when some godparents act ungodly? We got to switch some things up around here and use words wisely and correctly. And I will be doing a topic called Ungodly Godparents and Kids Who Make Bad Choices. Because at the end of the day, unforgiveness is what got a lot of people out here struggling with their walk. Doubt and unbelief and unforgiveness. But if you go on, verse 14 says, frowardness is in his heart. He devises mischief continually and sow discord. And then you read on, and it says, therefore shall his calamity come suddenly. Suddenly shall he be broken without remedy. And then that's when God went right in to say, these six things I hate. Yea, seven is an abomination. Because chapter 6 breaks it down. You can read chapter 6. It starts off verse 1, my son, and you can read it all the way over to where he says, he will not regard any ransom, neither will he rest content, thou though givest many gifts. Chapter verse 35. Read the book of Proverbs. It's right here. This is why God says that. And it also says up here that he doesn't like anybody that soweth discord. And that's the last thing, that sowing discord. That's really the abomination of it all. You sowing discord with your Christianity and what you believe. If that's what you believe, just go down your road, your narrow road. Speak your truth. And don't be out here fighting with everybody else, causing discord. Hold on, YouTube. You're getting more than Facebook. Yes, thank you. We're almost done. So you have to walk in your truth. Salafa, thank you so much. You have to walk in your truth. If this is what God's saying he hate, work on these things right here. I'd rather you work, if you work on these things right here, these, and you can manifest these things, when you get that kind of character in you, you ain't gonna want to drink. You ain't gonna want to smoke. You ain't gonna want to run the clubs. You ain't gonna want to fornicate. You ain't gonna want, you is that well done, my good and faithful servant. And you really assured that God loves you when you not doing these things right here. And I sit back so often, oh, God love me, I'm blessed. And I'm like, but, oh, they just ran to mischief. Oh, they just sold discord. Oh, they got a proud look. Oh, they just lied. Oh, man, they just shed blood. And you sit back like, oh, God says he hates that stuff. So what you gonna do? Keep sitting back, letting people do these things and not speak up and try to intervene on their behalf? Oh, you don't know what's in the Bible that Esau reached out. Was it Esau? I believe it was Esau, and wanted repentance, but it was rejected. You don't believe that, do you? Okay. when Facebook come in, we wrapping it all up right now. I'm not lying, I'm trying to get video time in here so that I can make a couple videos on YouTube. And I'm trying to, like I said, Salafa, I make videos on YouTube. You can check me out on hashtag Religion Week. I speak about what I'm speaking about here. I don't go over there doing nothing other than what I'm doing here. It's just trying to shine my light, the truth of life, into people, opening up eyes.